It was the summer of 84. Bryan Adams was in New York City working on the follow-up to his breakthrough album, Cuts Like a Knife, which had sold a million copies in the US.
I mentioned the fact that you go into the studio, and is it true you record like live? I mean, you put it right down?
Well, basically it's the band in the studio, all the guys, and we go in there and we just put it down and overdub afterwards, but basically it's the live band.
The new songs he recorded were good, he was sure of that, and he had what he considered the perfect title for a rock and roll album, Reckless. But still, he had this feeling that something wasn't quite right. He invited his manager, Bruce Allen, to New York and played him the album. Allen's verdict was straight to the point. Where's the rock? Those three words changed everything. Bryan called his co-songwriter Jim Valance.
What happens with Jim Valance and myself, the guy I write my songs with, is that we get into a groove where we just start, things start to really connect.
They wrote a new song from scratch, a song designed to answer Bruce Allen's question. Its title, Kids Wanna Rock. With his third album, Reckless, Adams plugged into that mainstream audience dominated by Bruce Springsteen, John Cougar Mellencamp, and Don Henley. But Adams was of a different generation to those established big hitters. He turned 25 on the day Reckless was released, November 5th, 1984. His hard rock sensibility, explicit in Kids Wanna Rock, was something that spoke to fans of Van Halen and ZZ Top. And the way he sang, belting it out like a young Rod Stewart, gave him that extra edge.
Down the barricade, listen what the kids say.
With Reckless, Bryan Adams created an album of hits that still resonates to this day. But it was no overnight success. Born in 1959, Bryan Adams was performing on the Vancouver music scene by the age of 15. He joined Canadian glam rockers Sweeney Todd and in 1979 released an album, If Wishes Were Horses. In 1978, he met Jim Valance, formerly of Canadian rock band Prism, and the two began writing songs together.
And he said, what are you doing tomorrow? And that was it. We got to together the next day and started writing tunes.
Later that same year, Adams signed to A&M Records for $1. His first minor hit was a remix of a demo of his, turned into a disco track called Let Me Take You Dancing with sped up vocals. Adams hated it so much, you can't hear it online to this day. Stung by the experience, he threw himself into making it on his own terms. He wrote songs and toured relentlessly.
Spent almost 3 years solidly touring in Europe and in the States and Canada, over and over and over and over and over. Developed a bass, put on a record, and it clicked.
Run to You had originally been written for Blue Oyster Cult, with an opening guitar riff that echoed their classic 1976 hit, Don't Fear the Reaper. When that band turned it down, Adams decided to use it. It was the lead single off the album and topped the Billboard rock charts. Summer of 69 was originally inspired by Bob Seger's Night Moves, a nostalgic song about adolescent rites of passage with images of cars, girls, and long hot summers. To begin with, Bryan was a little bit coy as to what the summer of 69 was about.
The thing about the summer of 69 is it's a metaphor. It's not actually about the summer of 69. I mean, it could be about the summer of 85.
Later, he came clean.
I never said 1969.
Oh, it's a metaphor for that.
It's a metaphor for a great summer.
Of love?
Wow. Summer of love, exactly. Thank you very much.
I'm going to just move on to a different topic here, Bryan.
Another song that came together quickly was one that Jim Valance had brought to the table. It's Only Love wasn't written with a vocal duet in mind, but Adams felt it needed another voice to make it special, and he had only one person in mind. Tina Turner.
I met Tina Turner probably about 6 years ago when she came to town and played a little club here in town.
Power Ballad Heaven was written for cheesy 80s movie One Night in Heaven. The movie stiffed, but the single became the biggest hit from Reckless, going to number one in Billboard's Hot 100. There were more singles. One Night Love Affair went top 20 in the US and Canada. Somebody was an instant sing-along classic. Reckless had more hits on it than most artists have on their actual greatest hits albums. It sold more than 12 million copies worldwide and transported Bryan Adams into rock's A-list. And the secret of its success? Great songs performed with heart. Because even at the height of synth pop in the new wave 80s, the kids wanted something less pretentious. And Brian knew it. They didn't just want to rock. They wanted songs they could sing along with for the rest of their lives.